This is The Aviators. With products to be used thousands of feet above the earth, manufacturers in the aviation industry have to have extremely high product standards. This applies not only to companies building main components, such as the airframe or engines, but also to the makers of the aircraft's displays and instruments. In everyday flying, pilots trust their lives to what their instruments are telling them. Mid-Continent Instruments, based in Wichita, Kansas, manufacture a variety of aircraft instruments, including their flagship product, the Lifesaver gyro. To find out more about the precision that goes into every instrument, the Aviators went to Kansas and met up with Mid-Continent President Todd Winter.
Well, Mid-Continent started as a service company, and we started because the aviation manufacturers were here. And we were doing service work for some of our key customers, and they actually approached us and said, "We have a problem. Can you help with this?" And they asked us to design replacement instruments. So we started on a small scale with just a few people, building very specialized parts, and really growing from there to where we then began to develop our products that we could sell in the aftermarket. So instead of designing to a specification, we would initiate the design.
Primarily focusing on general aviation, Mid-Continent has built a reputation around producing a high-quality product that's thoroughly tested. To achieve this, they employ manufacturing techniques that minimize the potential for defects. Lead technician on the Lifesaver gyro line, George Hooper, spoke to us in one of the labs where the final assembly is done on the Lifesaver gyro.
This lab here is where we build the instrument itself. The machining work is not done in here because of the cleanliness. You know, there's no grinding, sanding, or anything that needs to be done. If we have a part that is not exactly the way it's specified, we reject it and send it back to parts and get another one. This lab is kept at higher levels than a hospital's cleanliness. We have filtrations on some of our systems here down to 0.5 micron, which is way smaller than even a human hair. So this is solely set up here for manufacturing. Everything comes in sealed in bags. Our bearings are all individually sealed and packed so that they have no chance of being contaminated. When we apply them, they're done with clean hands or fingers are covered or with tools that are clean.
Mid-Continent's signature instrument is the Lifesaver gyro.
The Lifesaver gyro is an attitude indicator or a horizontal or horizon indicator. Some people call it an artificial horizon. Basically, it lets the pilot know the orientation of the aircraft relative to the earth.
An attitude indicator is going to basically tell you if you're nose up or nose down, which is called your pitch, like in an aircraft like this. Pitch up, pitch down. Also, when you roll right, roll left, and you're in a bank situation, an attitude indicator will give you that. It will tell you how far left, how far right, how far up, how far down you need to be, or that you are when you're flying in the sky.
The Lifesaver uses a gyroscope to display attitude information. Unlike traditional vacuum instruments that use air to spin the gyro, the Lifesaver's gyroscope is operated by electricity connected to the aircraft's main power.
So inside an attitude indicator is a rotor, also known as a motor, and that provides the gyroscopic action. It spins, creating the stability that allows the airplane to turn while the gyro stays in the same place, giving you a reference of pitch or bank. In a vacuum-driven system, the air pushes past that rotor with little fins around the outside of it, and that spins. That may spin at anywhere between 15 and 25,000 RPM. In an electric-driven system, it basically uses the aircraft's power to create a three-phase signal, which turns that rotor and produces the exact same action, just with a different power source.
Instrument flight rules, or IFR, are a set of regulations for when pilots can't see where they're going. This includes flying through clouds, storms, or while flying at night. Knowing the aircraft's attitude, altitude, and airspeed are always important to know, but they become crucial when flying IFR.
During a normal flight, when you're out at 7,000 feet, you can still see the ground, so you have reference as to where you're at. But during the night or during a storm or in the clouds or up when you get upwards in 20,000 feet, you start losing your bearings and your body can actually play tricks upon you as to what's going on. So you have to be able to trust what this gauge is telling you.
Pilots may find their aircraft flying upside down if they experience disorientation and fail to properly reference their attitude indicators and other instruments. In the past, this has led to pilots flying their aircraft into the ground while thinking they were actually pulling up. So what happens if your aircraft has an electrical failure cutting off the power supply to the Lifesaver gyro? Not a problem. One of the standard features of the Lifesaver is that it has a built-in battery backup that's able to supply up to an hour of internal power. This has led to the Lifesaver often being used in conjunction with glass cockpit systems. Regulations do vary by country and aircraft, so this instrument may or may not be required for your aircraft. But regardless, many owners are insisting that the Lifesaver gyro become part of their panel.
And if you think about the circumstances, if you're in a difficult situation anyway, your IFR, maybe you're on approach, when you have an unanticipated emergency or situation, the easier it is to transition or to check against your backup indicator, the safer it's going to be. You've got your hands full anyway. So having a second attitude indicator is often recommended and practiced by many people.
The Aviators, for everyone who has ever gazed skywards.
For more information on today's segments, visit www.theaviators.tv.